I've worked on 777X. That's been my previous projects. And now I'm currently on a military Air Force project for the B-1 bomber jet.
Boeing is the leading manufacturer and designer of a wide range of aerospace products, from planes to missiles, satellite equipment, and everything in between. And that's why I'm super excited to have Kaela Byrne. She is an industrial engineer at Boeing in Washington State. She actually gets to be very hands-on in the project management aspect of the testing of all of these different planes and the different aerospace products. So we're really excited. Kaela, thanks so much for joining us here today on Honest Careers. How did you end up in the aerospace industry, and how did you become an industrial engineer for Boeing?
So I studied industrial and systems engineering in college. I got a Bachelor of Science in industrial and systems engineering. And I applied for Boeing internships in college and got interviews and tried really hard and worked really hard at the interviews, and was able to intern twice out in Seattle area for Boeing as a college student, which was great. And so it really introduced me to the field. It gave me a really great feel for what I would actually be doing as an industrial engineer full-time at Boeing. And so after I graduated with my bachelor's, I accepted a full-time position at Boeing out in Seattle.
Super cool. Well, I want to dive in real quick for the people who are younger or earlier on in their career journey. Talk to me about some of the specifics during your internship in terms of what were you doing? Were you getting some cool hands-on experience?
So I would say very uniquely, the Boeing intern experience is you're put right on a team. You're the only intern on a team of industrial engineers. I'm sure it's very similar for other engineering disciplines as well. And so you're treated like a true team member. You're given projects, you're helping out with other teammates' projects. So it's a very full-on experience of what your full-time position would be like at Boeing, which was great. You're able to test out the job and get a feel for what you would actually do there. And so compensation-wise, it was actually way more than I was expecting. So relocation-wise, because I was from Florida, went out to Seattle, they fully compensate relocation, you know, living, if you need a car, all that type of stuff. So just a really great Boeing experience with the internship.
Crazy. So you're an intern, you do two internships for Boeing. What are you actually doing for Boeing now? Like, what does an industrial engineer do for Boeing?
Yeah, so I would say a typical industrial engineering role, you would actually fall into sort of a project manager type role. And so that just happens to be what my role currently looks like. So day to day, I happen to be in a testing organization. So I work within Boeing Test and Evaluation. And currently we are setting up and preparing for a B-1 bomber fuselage test. And so my day to day kind of leans on the project management side, like I said. So I kind of kick off the morning stand-ups, I run the morning meetings, I kind of gather the team, all the different types of engineering disciplines and other types of organizations that work on the project. I make sure everything's running efficiently. I am the master scheduler, so I control all of the schedules, critical paths, sequences, things like that, which, you know, it goes all the way from working with the mechanics on the shop floor, making sure their work is scheduled efficiently and ready to go, as well as all the way up to, you know, preparing schedules and charts and metrics for VPs and executives.
Are you on the commercial side? Are you on the military side?
Yeah, so I think the unique perspective I bring from the testing organization is that we test everything. So we could test something as small as a panel, or as large as a full-scale aircraft or military-grade, you know, jet. And so, surprisingly, the projects I've worked on so far as a young career person have all been full-scale commercial and military air products. So I've worked on 777X. That's been my previous projects. And now I'm currently on a military Air Force project for the B-1 bomber jet. And so the culture can be a little different, right? The commercial side is maybe a little more, we're used to that. That's kind of our bread and butter here in the Puget Sound area. It's kind of the norm. Not so much on the military side. It's a little few and far between around the country for that. And so working with the Air Force, having colonels around, having that type of force around, it kind of brings things into perspective that we are truly testing and creating products for our country. On the military side, we kind of start our morning meetings with people most likely from the Air Force or that side of the house going defense to kind of remind us, hey, we're testing this jet for our Air Force, the US Air Force. If we don't get this test on time, if we don't complete this, people's lives are at stake. And, you know, again, the same can be said from the commercial side, but having the colonels there and the Air Force present and that reminder every morning kind of definitely brings things home.
But obviously there's some pretty big headlines that come out when people think about Boeing. And so how, if any, has that impacted kind of what the culture of the company is like or how things have changed?
I think I have a very unique perspective of actually joining the company before, you know, 737 MAX issues, before a CEO change. And I was with the company while that changed, and also through the company with the pandemic and, you know, the wild changes we've seen in the airline industry. And so it's been a pretty wild young career so far, a couple of years. But to speak on the kind of the 737 MAX side of things and the CEO changes, I was able to see firsthand that culture change of maybe before, you know, obviously schedule pressures, those types of things happening and kind of maybe a toxic management culture, and able to see that shift with the new CEO and kind of more transparency, that the working level people feel more comfortable now raising the flag if something doesn't feel right and we're maybe rushing things for no reason, or we're trying to hit a milestone and it's just not going to happen because the engineers say so. The design engineers raise their hand and they say, you know, if we're going to get this done safely and with good quality, we need to take the time to do so. And I've been able to see that shift. You know, managers and executives are okay hearing that and they will have that conversation.
What's the outlook for the next 5+ years?
Yeah, I'm definitely the type of person that doesn't like to make a 5-year plan. You should always keep your options open. But with that being said, the amount of opportunity at this company, I think, is what keeps me going and keeps me energized, especially being in the organization I am in with testing. And there's always something new to test. It's very important to be in the testing organization, obviously, at a time like this. There's lots of work. But also the variety of projects. I've gotten to see commercial airplanes go through fatigue and static testing. I've gotten to see, you know, a bomber jet go through testing. I've seen, you know, all kinds of cool varieties of projects, and it's going to be endless. So that really energizes me that I can always have different options at Boeing. I think many different personality types would thrive as an industrial engineer. So I almost wouldn't say there are attributes that wouldn't, you know, be for a Boeing industrial engineer, because there's definitely the sustaining side. If you kind of want that sort of normal day to day, you know, very structured, standard type of work day, that industrial engineer is at Boeing. So there's that type of fit. And then I would say more of the industrial engineer I fall into, or industrial engineering role, is a big problem solver and project manager.
What kind of tips would you have for someone watching this video, either around industrial, around Boeing, just any words of wisdom?
Yeah, I think I have seen myself grow throughout the past 4 years at Boeing as an industrial engineer. You know, I don't think college can ever prepare you for the working field, but what I loved about it is that I was able to kind of take a backseat at the beginning. You know, maybe I was a little quieter, maybe I was a little more of a thinker, using that time to absorb and listen and watch my peers around me, you know, watch behaviors that were good, watch behaviors that were bad, and kind of let myself kind of mold on the inside. And then I've been able to see myself grow into that personality at work where I no longer feel like I have to be quiet. I feel comfortable speaking up. You know, I might be the only female in the room with a bunch of male engineers, but I still know I have a seat at the table and that my perspective is just as important as theirs. So I would really encourage, it might be, you know, it's hard starting off, you know, in the corporate world as an engineer, but I think we have the time to grow and absorb and become whatever you want to be.
Kaela, thank you so much for joining us today on Honest Careers. Everyone, look, if you enjoyed that interview, please give us a thumbs up down below in the video. And then if you have any questions at all, either related to industrial engineering or aerospace engineering or Boeing, please let us know and we'll do our best to answer them. And Kaela, thanks again for joining us.